Hi guys, welcome to Minutes 2 Energy. We are a team of solar professionals with more than 10 years of experience in technology and business fields, and today we are going to share our knowledge and experience with you. Please see the video till the end for useful resources. So let's begin. Hi, I'm Jenny, and today I'll be with you guys discussing near shading loss in solar PV system. Before we begin, allow me to share some important notes with you. We segmented the losses in solar PV system in four major categories based on our knowledge, experience, and mostly per industry's acceptance. First is optical losses, second, solar panel related losses, third is the DC to AC conversion losses, and last but not the least is AC system losses. Let's know more about the optical losses. Before we proceed further, please take note of two things. First, we are discussing at the solar PV module level, not at solar cell level. Because solar cells have their own different set of losses, and that is another video. And the second thing is, we are talking about the losses which are occurring at the module's tilt plane, and that is from GII onwards. So losses in irradiance happen due to tilt angle and azimuth, not covered here. Okay, lots of discussion already, let's come to the main subject now. So, in optical losses, first we should talk about near shading loss. As the term suggests, this type of loss occurs because of shadows on solar panels from the objects that are near to it. Now, this may happen because of two main reasons. First, the nearby obstacles like buildings, trees, overhead electrical lines may create shadows to nearby solar PV installation. And specifically, for rooftop installations, situations like service areas including water tanks, satellite dishes, air-conditioned chillers, etc. If such obstacles are there near to solar arrays that cause shades directly in the solar panel, then it is advisable to avoid such areas for solar photovoltaic installation. Likewise, for large-scale megawatt solar plants, shadows from transmission lines, which may passing by the PV site or within the PV plant, can cause shading on PV module's surface. In a similar way, even nearby wind turbines will cause shadow on solar PV arrays. Shading not only decreases the total electricity production of solar panels, but also can create thermal hotspots, which eventually results in long-term degradation of PV panels. There are some researches prove that these kinds of shadows cause junction diode failures and even fire hazards. You may easily find in the internet the reports of fire accidents happened in solar PV installations. And out of all these cases, more than 80% are because of partial shadings. Commercially, if you install solar panels in the shaded area, even the manufacturers won't provide you the product and performance warranty. This warranty normally for 25 years to 30 years of time. Just for such mistake, you'll end up losing your assets value. So, in any case, you should avoid installing solar panels in shaded areas. Consider taking the shade area on the 21st of December, as the length of shadow is highest on that day in a year. You may see in the picture that how, on the 21st of December, the shades are so long in their spread. Second is the inter-row shading. This occurs due to the shading from the modules that are ahead of each row, especially if the row spacing is narrow or if the tilt is high. To mitigate this issue, you have to keep a certain distance between two rows and at an optimized tilt angle so that there is no inter-row shadow during the peak operational hours. And obviously, by maintaining the GCR or ground coverage ratio optimized. This is a very complex scenario. We have covered the topics GCR and how to calculate inter-row spacing in separate videos. Do watch them for more insight. Back to the near shading loss. Again, in this case also, modules can develop hotspots, which result losses, not only in generation, but also both in safety and assets. So we highly recommend that during site survey and assessment, please make note of any nearby obstacles. And for sure, you'll lose your contract agreement of module warranty for such mistakes. And don't forget about the 21st of December, the longest shadow day. Due to inter-row shadings or nearby objects, annual shading loss, up to 2%, is normally considered to be moderate and within acceptable limits. So, while you will be designing your PV system in softwares like PVSyst, Helioscope, or in SketchUp, you should make sure of the exact amount of shadow loss by creating the 3D shading scene. Want to know how to design a 3D shading scene? Follow the link in description or click on the I button above. So, this is all about the near shading loss in minutes for your quick and in-depth resource. Please subscribe and press the bell icon for more of our regular uploads. Check the videos in this series of PV system losses too. Please let us know how did you find this video helpful in the comments section. We read all of your comments. And please like and share the video as much as you can. Do subscribe to our channel, Minutes to Energy, for more interesting videos on solar PV system. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.